Welcome back to the garden. I'm Melissa Allman, and today we're going to talk with Amanda Baxley. Now, Amanda recently won a competition, so Amanda, tell us a little bit about it.
I was in the bikini category for a Kentucky muscle competition, and I won second place.
Second place. Show us what you got.
This big sword here is a trophy that I was awarded. Watch out, Melissa, so you can get stabbed in the leg right there. But it is a real sword, and it's for second place, so real proud of that.
And we're cutting strawberries with that today.
That's off the video.
Organic fitness. All right, and Amanda, you look great. So
thank you.
That's why I wanted to talk with you and find out about some food. I was real interested in what you had to say. So when I walked in and I saw this, I really did like that plate of goodies. So tell me, what you think about it?
Well, typically, the key to success for anything is planning, okay? Even though if you're planning for a business plan or if you're making vacation plans, you have to get some organization first. And the same goes for your nutrition. You can't have a good diet plan if you don't plan out your meals. Typically, you want to make sure that you're eating six times a day. And most often, people find the hardest choices to make are for your snacks. This might be what we typically choose for our snacks. You've got peanut butter, chocolate, and oatmeal cookies, a Rice Krispie treat, chocolate chip cookies, donuts here, a festive Christmas tree, and also the Chex Mix that you have here, or the snack mix, is one of the 100 calorie packs, okay? Now, this is just enough just to make you mad. So, I don't know of anyone that when they are hungry for a snack, they only want this amount here. So, that's what this plate is.
Yeah, because the donut looks like it's yummy, so then you just have to have one more. So, but what about the peanut butter and...
It's got peanut butter and cocoa and sugar in it. So, it does have peanut butter, which is definitely a good omega-3. However, there's too much sugar in there to counteract or overtake the peanut butter benefits out of it. So, you're not actually going to get the benefits of the peanut butter because you've got way too much sugar.
Mm-hmm. And it sure is pretty. But it's...
This is not the plate of choice. And just to kind of offset this or give you healthy alternatives instead of this plate, the things that you want to try to select are your fruits and your vegetables and your good proteins and your healthy fats. So instead of these unhealthy carbohydrates, you want to try to move more towards the berries and the apples, bananas, fresh fruit. And even if you're on the go, you've got some cereal bars. These are kashi bars. They're made with whole grain and whole wheat.
Does this help you keep, does it keep your hunger down a little bit?
Absolutely. And the snacks in between your meals are definitely very important so that you don't overeat during your three meals out of the day.
The three normal meals. Mm-hmm. So if you're planning, say, to go somewhere, you just grab your apple, your orange, and just snack on them.
Okay. What you want to do, obviously you're going to have your three staple meals out of the day, but if you're going, say, shopping, or if you're planning for your next days of work, you can take your meals or your snacks alike and, you know, put them all together and get them ready for the next day, so that way you're not eating on the go, which is primarily our problem when making unhealthy choices because we're trying to grab something that's convenient and fast. So if we plan ahead of time, then we don't have to worry about that and we'll more likely make healthier choices. So what I have here is basically a cooler bag or insulated bag and then an ice block. So if you've got foods that you choose that you like to keep cool, then you just put them in here. And then this is actually a bag that's big enough that you can, you know, pack your lunch and then a couple snacks in there to tide you over during the day or even your breakfast as well. But it's not too big and bulky like a regular cooler.
And it's pretty.
Purple's my favorite color.
And it'll have yummy food in it too instead of the snacks.
Right, and also moving down the line here, you can also, you know, choose prunes or something like that, which I like to snack on, and it's definitely a good fiber source because a lot of times when people are thinking about dieting or healthy nutrition choices, they're going to try to eliminate the carbohydrates, which you want to make sure that you're making healthy carbohydrate choices as opposed to things that are on this plate. But this is also a good source of fiber, which is often overlooked whenever people are cutting back on their carbohydrates. And then also here, as far as your omegas, these nuts are definitely a good protein source. They have good omega-3s that your heart needs for good health. And you want to make sure that you're choosing unsalted, natural almonds or nuts so that they don't have any additives or preservatives to them. However, if you like more of a sweet, or if you have more of a sweet tooth for snacks, then this is cocoa roasted almonds. It doesn't have any additives. The only thing is it's covered with cocoa. And that only adds 6 carbohydrates and 1 gram of sugar.
1 gram of sugar. Mm-hmm. Wow.
And that's per serving.
And see, I like the sweet stuff.
Okay. And also planning for your day's snacks or a meal for lunch or something along those lines. If you need something on the go, a good idea is to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. It's not your typical peanut butter and jelly sandwich that you cut into a heart, make smiley faces on. But you want to make sure that you're using whole grain or whole wheat bread. Anything that says enriched flour is not true whole wheat. Okay, so you want to make sure that it says whole wheat flour.
And that's huge. That's a huge piece of bread. That's bigger than your other type breads.
And much more nutritious.
And much more nutritious.
And it does have the fiber that you need in there as well. And also, when you're making your sandwiches, you want to go for natural peanut butter as opposed to your regular peanut butter. Go ahead, Melissa.
What I thought was interesting, this is a natural. And the one I get, what did you tell me about that?
They're typically
fat or something?
Yeah, you can get the regular peanut butter and then also low-fat peanut butter. And people typically will choose low-fat or reduced fat because they think it's healthier, which actually it's not, because the regular peanut butter and reduced fat are full of preservatives and additives and things like that, and not as much of the quality peanuts, which the natural peanut butter is.
Wow. Okay. And then on the jellies, it's sugar-free, but it is a preserve.
Right.
So tell us a little bit about the difference in the preserves and the jelly.
When you're making your choices for your jellies or your jams or preserves, then you want to make sure you're choosing the jams and the preservatives as opposed to the jellies, because the jellies are made with fruit juice. The jams and preserves are made with whole fruit.
And I thought that was really interesting because I like the preserves and the jams.
And also, during the holiday season, you may be out shopping or, you know, on the weekends, out at the mall, you may want to choose your lattes, your cappuccinos, things of those nature, of that nature. Also, those will add an additional 300 to 700 calories to your daily intake just on the drink alone. They also add anywhere from 35 to 70 grams of carbohydrates. They have sugar and a lot of sodium as well. An alternative, a healthier alternative to that, is to use apple cider, spice cider. This brand specifically is sugar-free. It adds, I believe, 30 milligrams of sodium, which is incomparable as opposed to what you may find at 600, 700 in typical drinks. I think it adds
zero fat.
No fat. It's 15 calories and 2 grams of sugar?
It's got 4 grams of sugar.
I'm sorry, 4 grams of carbohydrates and no sugar.
No sugar.
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's definitely a good alternative to the typical drinks that you may have. Because I know anytime we're out, especially if we're shopping, then, you know, it's fun to stop by the coffee shops and the pastries and
The big ones.
Yeah, because it's just a snack, you know, what you're looking for. But just think about all of the extra sugar and the calories that's being added by those little snacks.
So how much is mine? Probably 700 calories or something. The ones that I like, you know, the big...
Yeah, if it's a large size, yeah.
840 is what I had heard, but I'm trying to say less than that.
Right, yeah. And I can see where 840 would be feasible. Because usually the small ones are just about 3 to 500. Yeah.
I like the big ones, yeah. So I'll have to be cutting that out. and taking my apple cider.
There you go, sugar
free apple cider. Okay. I think you got some stuff over here for us to look at.
Yeah, those are supplements. You've got some supplements that you want to make sure that you're taking on a daily basis to make sure that you're getting everything that you need. First of all, we've got vitamin C. Right now, the cold season, during the holidays, everybody's sick and got sniffly noses and everything. You want to make sure that you've got your vitamin C to help promote your immune system, okay? Then also, fish oil. Everybody's heard a lot about that recently. It helps for your cardiovascular fitness. It also helps for support your joint health as well, okay?
And what's your thought on the krill oil? Is that good?
Why don't you talk about that one, Melissa?
Well, you know, the krill being, like, you can take one of these versus, I mean, three of these versus one krill. Mm-hmm. And I thought maybe you had an opinion on that.
My opinion on that would be to take it at night so you're not burping fish oil all day long.
Okay, that's a good one. That is a good one.
Okay.
Because a lot of people complain about that when they take their fish oil, but it's so important to take.
Absolutely, absolutely. But a good way to get around that, because I have had a lot of people say, well, I take that and, you know, I suffer the consequences all day. Well, a good option or alternative for that is to take it at night before you go to bed.
And then you never know.
Yeah. Your spouse may know, but you'll never notice. The next thing we have here is just a multivitamin that everybody needs to make sure that they're taking on a daily basis to make sure they're getting all the vitamins and minerals throughout the day. And then the last one we have here is a calcium supplement, which also has vitamin D in there as well. You want to make sure that you're taking that so that you can help decrease the chances of you getting osteoporosis, which is bone deterioration, which is especially important as women as we get older. So you definitely mm-hmm. want to make sure you're taking a calcium supplement as well.
Now, Amanda, for folks like me, I have some vitamin B on my counter, and I've got the C, and I've got the krill, and I've got the multivitamins. And should I actually get on a certain regimen? Like, should I be more regimented in taking my vitamins? Or can I just, like, take the B today and the C tomorrow? And
you definitely want to make sure that you're on a schedule as far as your vitamins are concerned. You want to make sure that you're taking them every day, each one of them every day. Just like if you were on a workout program and you want to do that, you know, 4 days out of the week, your vitamins are the same way. If you're taking them on a regular basis, you want to try to do them around the same time each day. If it's in the morning or at night before you go to bed, either way. So that way you can kind of get on a schedule, because if you mix it up on a day-to-day basis and you're not taking everything, then you're very likely to end up only taking your vitamin C once during the week.
Right.
Whereas the same thing with working out. If you work out on a regular schedule, then you're more likely to stay adamant, and the same thing with your vitamins.
How about going out to eat?
Okay. When you're going out to eat, you want to try to make the healthier choices. Obviously, try not to take them, or try not to order things that are saturated with butter or oil. If you have things, usually a fish is a good selection, no matter what kind of fish you're eating. Tilapias are definitely a really good protein source, and usually those are fixed so that they're, you know, grilled or something along those lines. And you can always request that there's no butter put on there. You can always, even if you're having a steak, you can always request that they don't put any butter on there, because that's just added saturated fat that you don't need. And also with your vegetables and everything that you choose, you want to try not to go for the loaded potatoes, all right? Try to use a sweet potato instead of regular white baked potato. Don't, even if you do a white baked potato, make sure it's not loaded down with butter and sour cream, bacon bits and cheese. While it tastes good, it doesn't look good on hips. And also, when we go to a restaurant, you know, we often, if we go to, say, a steakhouse, for example, they'll give us a loaf of bread, possibly mm-hmm. a bowl of peanuts. Then we'll order an appetizer. Then we have a salad before our meal. So we're actually full, actually, before we get our meal.
True.
So we're having, for the most part, two meals in one. Because we've had bread, we've had peanuts, which is a fat and a protein source. And then we've also had our appetizer, which typically has something to do with a bunch of cheese and chips or something mm-hmm. along those lines. So we've had all of those things already, but we haven't even gotten to our meat and potatoes, so to speak.
Oh my goodness.
So you definitely want to make sure that you're watching everything that you eat, because a lot of times we don't count that. And then if we have sweet tea or if we have a soda or something along those lines, that's added extra empty calories.
So when we order our food, we should order a to-go box.
You can.
We
do. You can do that, yes.
Absolutely. Or just eat the bread. And
I'm only going to eat half.
The appetizers, yeah. And then take your meal to go.
Because usually it's oversized portions anyways when you order.
Right. So just make sure that you're conscious of everything that you're eating.
Portion size wise. Yes. Mm-hmm. That would be a good thing.
Yeah. And your vegetables, make sure that you're getting green vegetables in. If you do broccoli or spinach or something along those lines, you can still ask them not to add butter or oil to your vegetables as well. And if you're having broccoli, you don't want to eat broccoli with cheese, because most of the time the cheese that's served in restaurants is filled with oil and not milk.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just a processed type.
Absolutely.
Cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's so interesting. I've learned a lot today.
Well, good. I'm glad that you thank you for having me on. I'm glad that we talked about it today.
And I really like this plate over here. But I will take your advice and fix stuff like this.
So, but you notice there's two plates, one for you and one for me. I'm just kidding.
Can we split them?
I'll take half and you take the
other
half.
Do you ever eat at all? Do you ever eat?
Absolutely. Okay. If you deprive yourself of things that you enjoy, then you'll definitely be more susceptible to overindulging whatever you do. So you definitely want to make sure that you're getting the things that you like, and you know, if you have cravings, you want to fulfill those cravings, but you want to make sure that you're not overdoing it on a regular basis.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
I hope y'all learned a little bit about this. I think it's so interesting how we can just change our ways that we think about food. And I appreciate it so much.
All right.
And Amanda is my personal trainer, so I was getting worried, and that's why I wanted you to explain about everything.
Okay.
So, y'all, we sure do appreciate you watching, and we will see you next time.
This exercise I'm going to do is called front squats. The difference between this one and a regular squat, you put the bar across the front of your shoulders. That's going to help you emphasize more on the front of the legs or the quadriceps as opposed to the hamstrings.
Here is the heart's on fire. All nations.
bridge of the hip. Press up through the heel and the outer portion of the foot.